Hello, hi, my dear friends. Welcome to my channel HSR Bioinfo. Today we are going to discuss one more important organelle of cell, that is ribosomes. See, these are the organelles which are very essential for the protein synthesis of cell. So let us see the properties. Ribosomes majorly involved in the protein synthesis. These ribosomes initially identified by a scientist called as Pelade in the year of 1955. These ribosomes actually present in all eukaryotic cell. And prokaryotic cell. So, very few exceptions includes these ribosomes which are not present in sperm cells and also matured mammalian cells. Okay, these two are the places where actually the ribosomes which are not present. Okay, let us see these ribosomes which are present in prokaryotic cell and also eukaryotic cell. The prokaryotic cell that contains ribosomes as a 70S ribosomes. Whereas eukaryotic cell that contains ribosomes as 80S ribosomes. Here, the 70S ribosomes that again has two individual subunits, those includes large subunit and small subunit. Here also 80S ribosomes again has the two individual subunits, they includes large subunit, small subunit. Here, the large subunit of 70S ribosomes called as 50S, the small subunit is 30S. Is it right? The large subunit of 80S ribosome is 60S and small subunit of 80S ribosome is 40S. Many people got doubt here, there is only 70S ribosome, but here there is 50S and 30S both together called as 80S. How it is possible? Actually, this is not a combination. So, here you can see, here is a 70S ribosome, here is 50S and 30S. What is that means? For example, you can take 70S ribosomes separately and 50S ribosomes, 30S ribosomes. Here you can take a vessel or test tube. This test tube contains the 70S ribosomes, 30S ribosomes and also 50S ribosomes. You just assume it has a liquid. In this liquid, these subunits like 50S, 30S, 70S and also 80S and also 60S. And also 40S. So, all these individual components that are present in a vessel containing liquid. If we subject these tube into the centrifugation, then what will happen? Actually, the 60S ribosomes, that are sediment at the level of 60 Sedberg units. So that's why it is called as a 60S. S means Sedberg units are also called as a sedimentation coefficient. sedimentation coefficient. Like that, if you subject centrifugation to the all these compounds, the compound 40S that is sedimented. Sedimented means that are present in the liquid form that should be comes to the bottom of the tube. That is called as a sedimentation. So, the sedimentation rate of 40S ribosomes at the 40 Svedberg units. That's why called as a 40S ribosomes. Okay, if these two subunits, 60S and 40S together, that forms the 80S ribosomes. Is it right? That 80S ribosomes that are sediment at the 80 Svedberg units. That's why it is called as a 80S ribosome and also 60S individual component and 40S individual component. Here you should remember one thing, the S meant for only Svedberg units. That Svedberg units we will get in the centrifugation. Centrifugation of the all these components. Is it clear? So let us see. Okay, these ribosomes actually present in two forms. One form of ribosomes is a free form and second one is a bound form. Second one is a bound form. Let us see free form of ribosomes. Ribosomes which are present in the prokaryotes. Simply, they include 70S ribosomes. But such type of ribosomes which are also present in the organelles like mitochondria and also plastids of eukaryotic cell. This is very important point. Actually, the prokaryotes that contain the 70S ribosomes, such 70S ribosomes also contained in the organelles of eukaryotes, such like mitochondria and plastids. So, these are the free ribosomes. Coming to the bound ribosomes. Which means, the ribosomes which attach to the membrane structures we called as a bound ribosomes. Actually, these ribosomes that bound to the endoplasmic reticulum and nuclear membrane. These are the membrane structures. Endoplasmic reticulum is the membrane structure. Nuclear membrane is the membrane structure where actually these ribosomes can get attached. So, such type of ribosomes we call as a bound ribosomes. Is it clear? Here, the eukaryotic cells that contain the bound ribosomes. Again, along with that, bound ribosomes, the eukaryotic cells also contains the free ribosomes in the cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm. So, coming to the bound ribosome, how actually bound ribosomes can present? For example, you can see here, it is the endoplasmic reticulum or nuclear membrane. It's a membrane structure. It's a double membrane. The double membrane structure of endoplasmic reticulum or nuclear membrane that attached by the ribosomes. Actually, here you can see, there is a two types of ribosomes. The two subunits of ribosomes in which the large subunit of prokaryotic and eukaryotic. The large subunit that attach to the membrane structures like ER and nuclear membrane. This is a large subunit. These large subunit that attach to the membrane structure with the help of a protein called as ribonucleoporin. So again, see, the large subunit that attached to the membrane structures, whereas the small subunit that attached to the large subunit. The small subunit that attached, small one, it is a large one. The large subunit that is attached to the small subunit, or small subunit that is attached to the large subunit. Okay, is it clear? So next we have to see how actually the ribosome that contains the composition. What is the composition of ribosomes? Let us see. So see here the composition of ribosomes. Actually we know very well, it is a small subunit and also it is a large subunit. The small subunit of, here is a eukaryotes, and you can see here is a prokaryotes. See, this is a small subunit and is a large. It is small subunit and large. You have to see what is the composition. The protein, these are the ribosomes. These ribosomes that are composed of only ribonucleoproteins. Ribonucleoproteins. Is it right? These ribonucleoproteins, it means that ribonucleo means RNA. The protein means the different proteins. One more important point to be noted here, these ribosomes are non-membranous structures. Very, very important point to be noted. These ribosomes are non-membranous structures. So these non-membranous structures that is composed of RNA and also proteins. Eukaryotic cells, that is ATS ribosomes, contains 60 to 65% of RNA. I'm sorry. 45% of RNA and 55% of protein. Coming to the prokaryotes, same composition but 60 to 65% of RNA, whereas remaining rest of the percent, 35 to 40% is a protein. Is it clear? Now you can see the ribonucleoprotein that is present in the these ribosomes and also prokaryotic ribosomes. Here I mentioned the RNA. The RNA actually in the prokaryotes and eukaryotes is varied. Let us see the RNA which is present in the eukaryotic cell are divided into the four types, in which the large subunit that contains the three types of RNAs, whereas the small subunit that contains the one type of subunit RNA. See, let us see the four types of subunits of eukaryotic cell. The small subunit that contains the 18S RNA, rRNA means ribosomal RNA, whereas the large subunit that contains the 28S rRNA and also 5S rRNA and also 5.5S rRNA. So these are the four types of RNAs which are present in small subunit and large subunit of eukaryotic ATS ribosomes. Is it clear? Coming to the here, the small subunit of prokaryotic cell that contains the 16S rRNA Whereas coming to this large subunit, the large subunit of prokaryotic cell that contains the 23S rRNA and also that contains the 5S rRNA. 5S rRNA. Again, here S is a segmentation coefficient or Swedberg units. So let us see what are the how many types of rRNA which are present in eukaryotic cell are the four types. The prokaryotic cell that contains the only three types of rRNA, ribosomal RNA. Here the common point to be noted, the common point to be noted here is a 5S rRNA which is present in both prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell, especially in the ribosome. Is it clear? This is all about the composition of the ribosomes. Composition of ribosomes. Is it clear? So, what we have discussed, different kinds of ribosomes in the prokaryotes and eukaryotes, and its functions, somewhat little bit functions like protein synthesis, and also we have discussed different compositions of the prokaryotic ribosomes and also eukaryotic ribosomes. Is it clear? So, in this way, the ribosomes are composed and which are present in the prokaryotes and eukaryotic cells. The rest of the part, actually the protein synthesis part, especially the function of these ribosomes is a protein synthesis. That protein synthesis part I will discuss in the next session. Okay, I hope this is a very clear to understand. If you really like this video, please do subscribe my channel HSR Bioinfo. Don't forget to like, share and comment. Thank you.